I am Nisira. I am an Alpha Chi consultant, and today I make this video on the topic of peace in relationships. So most people, as we grow up, we adopt an idea, an image of peace, of what peace is in relationships and society that is a bit false. So we believe that the real peace is when relationships flow in harmony, when there is an undisturbed flow of love, when there is no fight, when there is no opposition and no friction. But this way we end up to judge our relationships as successful or not successful, when in reality success in a relationship is when all participants can fulfill their purpose, their role, and the purpose of the relationship. I believe it's time that we start using our relationship in ways that we can grow, in ways that we can be empowered. And this way, when we are mutually empowered and mutually growing, our peace is growing, and the peace in the world is growing too. So for me, to have healthy relationships, it firstly means that we are in peace with ourselves. And to me, to be in peace with myself, it means that I know who I am, and I know my position in life, my role in life, and my purpose. Overall, this means that I have recognized myself. And if I am capable to recognize myself, I then recognize the person that stands in front of me. I can recognize who they truly are, and I can recognize their position in life and their part in their mutual relationship. To have peace in relationships, it also means that we allow each other to be who we truly are. It means that we allow each other to be free and to be true to ourselves. And this way, we can really accept the other person for who they are, and we can jump out of this pattern that we constantly need or wish the other people to change. And when things get really hard in a relationship, this is when we really start thinking that there is something we can change in our behavior or in our state or in the way that we deal with the relationship and the other person. So now we can slowly start to understand in which ways it is important for us to change, so we can be in peace no matter what. And following this, examining ourselves and changing, doing the work for ourselves, three things are happening. First of all, we can honor the relationship for what it is, and we can give to every relationship its real worth. And then we allow to every participant in the relationship to fulfill themselves and fulfill the purpose of the relationship from their own position. And in the end, we can keep it clear for ourselves how it is possible for us to relate with other people. So, how can I relate? How is it possible for me? And how am I available to relate with the other person? By doing that, we can clear the field of the relationship from expectations, from attachment, from emotions and inner filters that only darken the field of the relationship, and they cover the truth of the relationship, which is the truth that unites people in relationships. It is really very important to always stay open to the other person and always stay open and grateful to the other person for who they truly are. And in this way, we can really receive the gifts and the qualities that every person brings into a relationship. We can be grateful for all the things we are sharing in a relationship and for all the things that we are learning from each other. A state of gratefulness helps us remember that the other people are always there to remind us something. And in relationships, we can really be reminded and we can really learn many things concerning what I am, who I am, or who I am not, what I want and what I do not want in my life, what I need and what I do not need, what I can do, how can I become better, or what I cannot do, and maybe I can start working on it. So really, the other people remind us who we truly are. It can be that people in relationships, they with their behavior, they can disappoint us, they can create pain, they can cause pain, they can make us feel angry, they can disturb us, and they can challenge us. And this way we are given one more time the opportunity to examine and feel for ourselves whether we need to stand in our power more, or maybe that we need to learn, or that we need to dare to set healthy boundaries, or they are teaching us to trust ourselves more, or even despite the wounds of the past, that we should keep trusting people no matter what, or that we should stop depend on others for our happiness, for our fulfillment, and that we should stop filling our inner gaps and to depend on others for that. Honestly, the lessons we can take in relationships are innumerable, and we should always be open and grateful to receive the lessons and cherish the other person and honor them, because they are giving us these chances to learn and to grow. So I wish you to always be able to enjoy your relationships, to see them for what they really are, and to be able to honor the person in front of you, and use your relationships in ways that are beneficial, in ways that both people, both all participants are honored, and in ways that the relationship serves everybody, and ways that you can grow and become a better person, in ways that your peace is growing and it can spread, it can expand and influence peacefully more people and the world. Thank you for listening.